How's it going? So, today I am making a terrarium. I'm going to make it in this jar. And I'm now currently in the bushlands of Ilden. And this is where I'm going to be collecting all the stuff for it, apart from the charcoal. That's going to be from the house fire at my place. Just because that's easier that way. So first up, I'm going to get rocks from there for the base layer, and then I will go from there. So I shall be seeing you shortly. So I have the first layer done, rocks in a jar. Now to go and get the charcoal, then dirt, then moss, and then to hopefully find a couple of nice plants to put in around it, make it look pretty. So I'm now on a bit of a walk now, so I'm going to a specific spot that I quite like and have liked since I was quite young and exploring the area. But it's got a really nice moss grounding. And yes, I know that there is moss right there on the ground behind me. But I don't want that moss, so I'm going for a walk now to get it. It is a bit of a hike, so bear with me. I might see you again a couple of times throughout if I see any nice little plants that I reckon might make it a good terrarium, so yeah. So while I'm out here walking, there's a kookaburra for one. We're gonna flip you around. I just missed him. So why am I building a terrarium? Well, first of all, terrariums themselves are essentially a bit of a plant thing in a jar. But there's a bit more than that. You're building your own micro ecosystem. So, I mean, there's hundreds of thousands of different types of terrariums. I'll put some here. And so I decided the creative project for uni that I'm doing this for, actually says that it's all about sustainability and sustainability thinking. And I was thinking for quite a long while. I didn't want to write an essay, so it was that. And with all of that, I came to the idea of, terrariums are their own little sustainable ecosystem within themselves. And for the creative project, you had to use found or recycled objects. And I figured I know where some nice little things are around the place, so why not use those? I'm using the jar that you've seen before. Again, I'll put a picture here if you really want to see it again. I'm using that because, it was a old Makona coffee jar, and my parents were going to throw it out, and I was just like, don't, I'll make something out of it one day. And that day has come, so almost there now, just got to go halfway up a hill, which is good fun. I decided to make a terrarium because it's sustainable and it's kind of a nice little thing to do. They look good, and yeah, I decided that it's a good way of sustainable thinking. So, yeah, we'll talk again when I climb the hill. So I found the moss right there. I'm gonna dig that up, put it in, and yeah. I guess I can talk a little bit more about how it's sustainable and all that. So, the terrariums, they're, as I said before, a micro ecosystem. And essentially what that means is that, they're ideal for college or uni students like myself, because they require very little effort to keep them alive. And So there's that aspect of it, but what that means is that they don't need to be watered or fed anything, because everything that they need is already there, and they then start to create it again and again afterwards, like after it's sort of started up. So, you know, that's why you have the charcoal to clean the water once you put the little bit of water in to begin with. The moss is to, you know, it's a moist thing. It helps with the stopping, essentially, water jumping around the place. The rocks are there to act like the ground bed. So, you know, water can get down there, but it then doesn't stop the plants from being drowned like it would if you just put dirt in. And so, yeah, and then you have the plant itself, which typically is a succulent, being that I am in central Victoria. We don't have many succulents out here, so I don't know how well it will actually last once it gets around to lasting, but hopefully it should do alright when I find a plant. Might put a bit of a fungus in there, mushroom, small little one. But yeah. So it's kind of like a mix between a greenhouse and a what are they called? The water-based plant garden things. I dress something. But yeah, so I'll dig up the moss now. Where is it? And I'll put it in the jar, take pictures, also actually show you the charcoal in the jar is probably a bit important for it, since I forgot to do that since I was at home. Just kind of grabbing it out of the dead fireplace, which shouldn't really be dead considering that at the moment it's like 8 degrees in Ilden. So, yeah, kind of cold. But, you know, you got the charcoal in the jar, it looks like a complete mess at the moment because it's been rummaged around on my back in a backpack. Sorry about that, but yeah, so let's do this. That's starting to look alright, I think. Yeah, I reckon it looks alright. Now to hopefully go and find some ferns. They tend to look nice in these. Maybe a few mushrooms, but yeah. Now it's starting to come together. Shall see you. That was actually quite quick to finding mushroom, hopefully, pointing to it. So yeah, now I'm going to put that in the jar, and then hopefully find a fern thing soon, or other plants, who knows. So I don't actually know if these mushrooms are poisonous or not, so don't eat. Probably the best advice I can give, but you know, I might put a couple in here, make it a little fairy garden, even. Who knows? I'm not gonna actually do that. That's yeah, no, I'm not gonna find a tiny little house. And I mean, I might put another one or two in there. The reason that doing this is because La Trobe University has this multiple essentials. They're pretty, really good essentials to try and think about, but the problem is that a lot of subjects don't actually talk about them at all. And So when the Exploring Creative Arts subject that I'm currently doing, for its final assessment, it asks you to think about the sustainability essential and the sustainability thinking essential. So I did. You know, I went and actually looked about the sustainability resources that Latrobe does. We're cutting off fossil fuels completely in a couple of years, apparently. But additionally to that, it's that, yep, the thing is that future generations of Earth are pretty screwed over. I mean, hopefully I'm going to be part of the generation that starts to make an effect and start fixing that. But I really don't know. I hope we do. I want to, but there's only so much one person can do. But, you know, recycling and all of that, and, you know, composting and even making our own stuff would make a massive difference to the planet. And, like, you don't even have to think planet-wide. You can just think about how you're going to improve your town or your community. And, I mean, most of us live in pretty good places. I mean, I know that I am one lucky son of a bitch to grow up in the area and the town that I have. But I know that so many other people from this, you know, town, this area, take it for granted, which sucks. Like, it's lucky for me, because I'm kind of outdoorsy, you could say. I mean, bush. And willingly doing this, actually. Like, we're doing something completely different. I could be writing an essay or something else along those lines, but I'm not. But, you know, we live in this gorgeous, beautiful town. Sure, most people only come in summer when everything's, like, dead and dry. But in winter, yes, it's absolutely freezing. But, you know, look at all of that. Hopefully you can. But all of that, it's a gorgeous town. I love it. But, you know, one day all this is probably going to be gone. It'll be built into something completely different. And it won't feel anywhere near what it does now. And that's why sustainability is important, because as much as all of this stuff, it is absolutely gorgeous and everything. If we keep going how we have for the last, I can't even say century, because it hasn't. It's literally just been the last maybe 5 decades. So the last 50 years. And already we have screwed over the planet more than any other point in history, as far as we can tell. And we can tell this from multiple things. Some of them being the ice caps. Other things just being, you know, looking through the rocks and all that sort of stuff, and actually looking at how the Earth has been since its creation, I guess. And, you know, those things are really quite concerning, because we all live on this Earth, and we should be trying to take care of it, but we're not. So, yeah, sustainability is one of the more important things that we need to focus on throughout, well, for the next probably 100 or so years, because without a sustainable Earth, and without our space exploration actually being a thing, we're kind of screwed if we keep screwing it up, I guess. So, yeah, I think I see a bit of a fern just up ahead. So, yeah, I'll talk to you again soon. So, being that that wasn't as successful as I had hoped it would be, I am on the search for more plants. So, yeah. What else can I talk about it with sustainability? I guess. If we as a culture and society become more sustainable, we can hope to maybe not even have to leave this Earth. I mean, we already have all the stuff, really, to start being more sustainable. We can cut out fossil fuels, you know. We have solar power, we have wind turbines and wave turbines. And the reason, to my knowledge, that we haven't is because, well, that doesn't make much money. You know, you always hear the slogans for them is that, you know, solar energy free from the sun. And so that means that the big mining companies, the ones who dig and sell fuel for $1.30 a litre or something like that, means that they then stop making money, which isn't wanted. A couple of kangaroos scared the jeebus out of me. But the thing is that at the moment that's how the world runs. It runs on money. If you don't have money, you don't have the same privileges as those who do. Which can often mean no education. Could mean no food even for some. But, you know, I'm not trying to push socialism or stuff like that. It's a flawed system in itself. But it's like, we have electric cars, we don't even need to be using petrol anymore. Like, these cars are, at most times, well not most times, but the top quality ones are at a spot where you don't actually really need to, you know, have a heavy diesel car, like you can probably hear in the background. Because I don't think I'm going to put music over this, but you know, as a species, we are destroying more and more species of other animals. You know, one day soon, you might never hear that. The life of a kookaburra. And like, that sort of stuff is heartbreaking. Like, as much as, yeah, those kangaroos before, you know, the sudden movement scared me a little bit. Startled me, I should say. Without all those, the world wouldn't really be worth living in, I don't reckon. Because you then have no nature whatsoever. And that then means that everything is man-made. It's just not good. So, yeah. Yeah, that's why I think the sustainability thinking essential that Latrobe has is good, but it also needs to be pushed more, because until this class, I hadn't thought about it. And even during the class, it wasn't really brought up that much, which is kind of both weird and upsetting now that I've actually looked into all of it. And I'm having no luck with finding plants either. But that isn't going to stop me from continuing to search. I mean, I have all day, which is the good part about finishing this last minute, is that, you know, all of my other subjects are finished, so I can just spend a day wandering the back bushes of Ilden, looking for little plants that might look good in a terrarium. No, those. But yeah, it's been good so far. You know, a bit of nostalgia from coming back home and wandering the places where I used to entertain myself as a kid before I had, you know, the technology that I do now. But also still being able to use the technology that I have now and be in the bush and enjoy it still. It's a good change. Yeah. Well, I suppose I'll see you again when I find some more plants. So, I'm now back home, as you can tell by curtains and couch and all that. And I have the terrarium fully made. And it looks pretty cool. I'll probably add in a better video clip of it made and everything. Sorry, I forgot to go and film the rest of the getting the plants and stuff like that. I was getting kind of tired. A lot of walking yesterday. Yeah, sorry about that. But, you know, there are plants in there. They look good. Yeah. So, terrarium is made. Now just to put it all together, video it, and hopefully that'll be good enough for the assessment that I'm doing this for. Yeah, for all of this, I had inspiration from a couple of places. One of them was a Zantoro video on YouTube, which I'm going to link to, actually, which it's about sustainability and what it is. Watching that gave me the idea to make the terrarium, which, yeah, I have the video going here now, maybe. So with all of that, they talk about sustainability and that, and that's where I've gotten a lot of what I've said from. I hope you've enjoyed the adventure that I went on, and I hope you'll enjoy looking at the terrarium. The light isn't great for seeing it, sadly. But yeah, so I hope you've enjoyed. Feel free to watch my other stuff. There isn't that much and it's not that good, but I'm getting there. So yeah, have a good one.